For today's project, I ran over to my local Home Depot and grabbed some planters right off the shelf, and also grabbed some primer and some textured finish that comes in many different colors. First part of our project is you're going to, when you notice at the end, you can do this any way you want. We're going to go with this square base. One of the pots that we're going to use right here, these do have removable bottoms right here. So what we want to do right in the beginning is we do want to have some glue on there. So we're going to put some glue here right around the edges. As you can see, this gives us a nice smoother edge to glue to. We're going to bind this pot right here on top of this base. So the easiest way to do this is you can mark the outline on the bottom, or you can just turn it over and put glue around the edge. So what we need to do is put the glue all the way around the edge. I'm a little shaky and I don't like doing that, so I'm going to put some glue just on a paper towel. And then what I'll do is I'll just take the glue and I'm just going to wipe it around the edge just like this. Doesn't take much, and it can be a little messy. The reason is, if it oozes out, that gives us some texture on the bottom. So just go ahead and put it all around the edge, just like this. So the next step is we're going to take our glued pot, just like this, put it right on top. You want to make sure you get the right size so that it doesn't come over the edge. The one thing about glue is we're going to put some weight on this. I just grabbed a quart of stain and put that on there. It gives it weight. Now, see how the glue is popping out around here? That's okay. Just take it, wipe it around the edge. Not a big deal. Once we get to the point that we paint and stain, you're not going to need to worry about this. So clean it all up. Now we're going to set this to the side and work on our other half. For the second part of this, we're going to take this waterproof container right here, flip it over. We're going to use the second part of our pot. It's going to match. Now the great thing is it fits right inside this grooved area inside here, right inside the pot. I made sure I did that when I was purchasing it. So I can just take the glue now and just put it all inside here. I don't need to worry about putting it on the edge of the pot. Again, it's okay. Put plenty on there. Be really liberal with it. Do not worry about putting too much. If it oozes out, like I said, we can take care of that. So lay that glue inside there. We need this to be as steady as possible, and it's going to hold really well. Once we got the glue on there, go ahead and take our pot, put it right inside there. Again, we got to make sure this base is glued on also. Give it a little bit of a twist, just a little bit. It's going to be in there. Now, see this textured on the bottom? Just go ahead and wipe at it. Again, you're not going to see this on the end product. Just wipe it all right there. We're going to go ahead and put some weight on that also just to hold it. Let's give this about 30 minutes and then we'll combine the two. After we've got all this glued together, we're going to go ahead and put some glue right on top. That's going to join these two pieces. Again, don't think you're putting too much on. It's okay if it comes out. I'm going to put all of this on that I can and let it just squish down inside there. Now, want to make sure that we get it just centered perfectly. I love this glue. It takes a little bit to set up, but it is going to be strong. If there's any glue that came out, go ahead and treat it like it's caulking. Fill in this gap right here. Now what we're going to do is just let that set up, and then we're going to take it outside. I laid down some cardboard, and I want to put on a good coat of primer first. I cannot emphasize enough how important primer is. So we'll get all this primer on. All it has to do is dry for about 30 minutes to an hour, and then we're going to get to our textured paint. I went with an off-white cream color, started spraying it on. This stuff's a little bit on the high side, but you want to go ahead and just get it all over, and it's just going to look really good. Get every square inch. Once that all dries up, I'm going to show you the multiple uses for this urn. It's going to be outstanding. One of the first things you can use it for is a bird bath. Go ahead and put it out there and let those little flying critters come around. Another use for this is to plant flowers in. Look at how good that looks right at your front door. It would definitely be a conversation piece. We make these because it saves you a lot of money and you don't have to buy these. We hope you enjoyed this project and its many uses.
We're going to show you how to take these dollar store tin buckets and create your very own springtime planters. Just finishing up with our twine. Now that we have our twine on and our super glue is dry, we're going to start with the fun part. Now we're going to take our tins one at a time. We'll turn them upside down We're going to be using Fusion paint because Fusion paint does not have to be sealed. And we're using these daubers, these wooden daubers. We'll dab some paint on. And we're going to start our process of creating daisies. So this is going to be the center of each flower. Does not matter if they're perfect or not. Okay, so we have our large dots all the way around. They're not perfect because they don't need to be perfect. Now we're going to take our smaller dauber and we're going to create the petals. Some can be spaced farther apart if you want. Some can be closer together. Okay, so we've got all of our flower petals, flower centers, and the little petals on. Of course, we want to make the back where the seam is right here. So we're going to make that the back. So that's why I turned it around for you guys. We are going to take some of our yellow paint and a small art brush. We'll come up here. We're just gonna add some yellow. Trying not to add tons. And we're just putting little dots of yellow on there to create our daisy effect. Okay, so we got all the flowers and the petals with the yellow completed on this one. I'm going to show you guys real quick how I just used this Loctite super glue to fuse these two together. Does not take long or much glue, and you don't have to do the whole surface. Like I said, we have not used much glue at all, and we're going to make both of these a little bit different. I'm going to show you this one and how I glued it on. We'll let this one dry, but I already did this one, which is a little bit different than the one that we just did. On this one, we put the daisies on both. On the second one that we did, we just put the daisies on the top. So I'm going to add a cup full of River Rock pebbles. And we're going to start adding some of our plants. And back here, we'll put our little baby one that isn't quite set up. I hope you guys love our spring planters with hand-painted daisies as much as we do.